this choir. Amen. Thank God for music ministry. Amen. Tis the old shepherd of Zion. Tis the old shepherd of Zion.
Louder, louder, louder.
of where we left off last Sunday, chapter 12 and verse 32. John chapter 12 and verse 32. Let me say thank you to Sister Mims for she's already got one of our signs already and it's ready to go up and it is beautiful. When we come into the Evergreen Church, nobody gonna have to remind you what we come here to do. Because every corner you turn, you're gonna see a sign saying lifting Jesus. Amen. You're gonna see a sign. When you come in, you're gonna see lifting Jesus. When you go out, over your head, you'll see lifting Jesus. When you go into the fellowship hall, you're going to see lifting Jesus. You just might see it when you go in the bathroom. Because that's what we come here to do, to lift Jesus. To lift Jesus. It's not about me, it's not about you, it's all about Jesus. And if we come and get and lift Jesus, we get a whole lot of other stuff done so easy. Amen. But we're going to got self out the way. John 12 and 32, the words of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, our theme verse of the Evergreen Church, and I. We dealt with that on last Sunday. If I be lifted up from the earth, will draw all men unto me. Lifting Jesus. Amen. Lifting Jesus. One of the things we shared on last Sunday was that if we, the Evergreen Church family, if we're going to reach those heights that I know we can reach, we must do it by lifting Jesus and getting self out of the way. Amen. We've got to focus on Him and Him alone. Listen what Jesus says as I began to dissect this verse and the words of the text. We had shared last Sunday that the words of the text, the opening of the text, and I, that there was previous conversation, there was something previously that had been talked about.
Yes, sir.
One of the main things is getting me out of the way and glorifying God. Jesus says, he says, if, this two little word is found 1,420 times in the scripture. If it is used to say that something must happen before another thing can happen. Talk to me. If you do this, then I'll do that. Jesus says, if
Yeah.
If, in other words, it's there's a choice to be made. If I'm not forcing this on you, but if you say you are who you say you are, you say you are a child of God, and if you are who you say you are, it should not be a problem. You should not feel that what I'm asking you to do is being forced on you, because I've discovered in my life that whatever the Lord asks me to do is for my benefit. It's not for his benefit, because
Yeah.
not a cowboy, Frank.
You say Michael Jordan, I say LeBron. But when I say Jesus, he's in a class. He got a right to say if I, because there's nobody can match up with him. There's nothing greater than him. He's all in a class. He says if I. This is Jesus speaking. He says, if I, then he says, if I be, we're going to break it down here. We're going to break it down. If I be, here used to indicate the condition of a person or man. Watch this. The word. Is in a bad condition. I said, this one, come on, y'all. Is in a bad condition.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Shooting all over the land. You're not even safe in your own house. Not safe even in the church house. At the movie theater. This world. Men hooking up with.
Y'all got quiet with that. Let me move over to this side.
Women marrying. Women, watch this. And it has become the law of the land. Stop here. Come on. if I be lifted. And what lifted is to raise from a lower to a higher position. From a lower level to a higher level.
Get a fat!